On the Medical Watch, Alzheimer's disease is growing at a rapid rate, with nearly 6 million people living with the disease in the United States. A new effort is underway to spot the disease earlier, simply by looking in the eyes.
So you're going to bring your chin into the chin rest.
So we want you to try to stay as still as you can. So you're going to look straight ahead. Right in the center, you're going to see a flashing blue light. Let me try not to blink. Go ahead and open again and hold right there.
A special scan, images of blood flow to the eye, and a finding that may help halt Alzheimer's disease. I volunteered my eyes for today's explanation of how the process works.
What we look for is the change in the capillaries. So we could see, so these are the tiniest capillaries in the back of the eye. And what we found is that people who are cognitively impaired, just around the center of the eye, right here, these small capillaries were slightly smaller, but in a statistically significant way.
The patients have to be matched by age, sex, and race. One, a healthy control, and one previously found to have cognitive impairment, are compared. Their eyes are scanned using optical coherence tomography angiography. Simply speaking, a minute-long test where two pictures are taken every 3 milliseconds.
If there's any change, any movement between those 3 milliseconds, that is considered something that's moving. So whatever's moving shows up here. Whatever's not moving shows up here, and the difference between them is blood flow and structure.
The difference cannot be seen by the naked eye, but computer calculations consistently showed those with diagnosed memory issues had less blood flow in the eyes, perhaps due to inflammation caused by plaque buildup in the brain. It's what doctors typically look for to identify Alzheimer's disease.
Biomarkers in the brain, biomarkers in the spinal fluid are being used, but we hope that this test can be part of that algorithm, another piece of evidence to support the diagnosis and help people being put to the right path and treatment.
While there is no real treatment for Alzheimer's, Sandra Weintraub, a neuropsychologist with Northwestern's Alzheimer's Disease and Cognitive Neurology Center, has studied Alzheimer's and dementia for decades. She says if this test works as it appears to, it will help.
So if we had some way of early identification, we would be way ahead of the game and could try to institute interventions that could prevent the abnormal proteins from accumulating and causing the cognitive decline. There are things that you can do in your lifestyle to help maintain brain health, like exercise and eating well, sleeping, not drinking too much alcohol. So you may adopt lifestyle changes that could push your risk.
And patients could plan their future before memory problems interfere. Bottom line, this latest research could delay the disease even in people whose eyes reveal the signs.
I'm very excited about the potential for preventing Alzheimer's as opposed to treating or curing it.
Northwestern is also currently studying a medication to reduce amyloid buildup in the brain. To get involved and find out more about this research or the retinal scan, check the link on our website.